Meantime, from one management voice to another, let's get in Bajaj Electricals. And this time it's been a bit of a soft quarter. The profits are down about 10%, revenues at 1,029 crores. We have Anant Purandare, who is the CFO of the company, with us on the show. Thank you for joining in on ET Now. It seems like the GST impact has hit numbers this quarter. So give us a sense of the total hit on volumes and whether or not you're seeing things stabilize into the coming quarters.
We have growth in the top line. It is mainly because of our engineering and project division. And as you rightly said, there is a hit on the consumer business because of the GST impact. We have given the compensations of around 10 crores to the distributors for setting off their loss of on account of GST. And if you look at the, though there is a drop in profit at profit before tax from 36 crores to 32 crores, but this 32 crores is after the hit of 10 crores, which we have given the one-time compensation to the distributor.
But tell us, are we going to see further contraction in your margins, or do you sense there could be an improvement from the next quarter?
I am not able to hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Right. I was wanting to know about your margins and whether or not they will continue to contract going further, or do you see some improvement coming in from Q2, Q3 onwards?
As I told you that we have taken the one-time hit of 10 crores, and there is a drop in top line of around 14 crores in consumer durable. So if look at this, the contribution loss because of drop in top line is around 12 crores plus 10 crores which we have given to the distributors. So around 21 crores we have lost, and which is if you see, it is more or less equal to the last year's EBIT margin. However, we are expecting that our top line should grow in future because we are rolling out the new distribution model, and which is almost 50% done, and balance is to be completed by March 18. Once that is done, we'll go on the again growth track.
All right, fair enough. So what's the outlook on your EPC revenues and the consumer products revenues? You spoke about the GST impact that has hurt it. So will we see them reviving, or will EPC be the growth driver?
In fact, we have taken a target of 5,000 crores, that is around 15 to 16% growth in the top line for the financial 18. We are expecting that consumer business should grow at around 10%, and engineering and project business should grow more than 20 to 25%. Because current order book for EPC is around 3,300 crores, and it is mainly for the power distribution of 2,600 crores and 600 crores for transmission line tower, and around 170 crores for high mast and street light. So such a strong order book will obviously enable us to achieve the turnover which is expected of around 20-25% growth in EPC, and at company level around 5,000 crores.
Okay. What about the LED business in particular? How has that been performing, and will it account for half of your lighting business revenue for 2017-18?
You are rightly mentioned about the LED, because our conventional lighting is degrowing very fast, and it has been replaced by LED for the both the businesses, consumer facing as well as commercial lighting fitting. So conventional is really degrowing very fast, and at the same time the LED lightings are growing more than double. So it has been getting replaced, but at the same time there is always a pressure for the margin for the LED.
Okay, you've been working on restructuring of the consumer products business as well. How's that coming along, and what can we expect in terms of guidance?
As I said, that the new distribution model which are rolling out, we are more than 50% through, and the balance geography we have targeted to complete by March 18.
Okay, thank you for sharing with us the outlook on Bajaj Electricals. Clearly, the GST impact has been felt, but going forward, there is a revenue target set at 5,000 crore rupees, and the new distribution model will help the company go back on the growth track. By the way, despite an okay set of numbers, the stock is holding out in the green at 330.